They're not questioning whether or not you are actually saved or not. They know that you're living a godly life. It's very confusing to spouses that are unsaved and even children to see one parent proclaiming Jesus and yet living a different lifestyle. So now go with me over to 2 Timothy chapter 1 and verse number 5. We can pass down a legacy to our children and our grandchildren just by how we walk out our Christian walk as examples and models of Christ. And we see this in the scriptures here in 2 Timothy 1, 5. Now look at verse number 5. It says, I remember your genuine faith, for you share the faith that first filled your grandmother Lois. He says, wait a minute. I see faith in you because I know your grandmother had it. And it was genuine and it was real. It's nothing like being genuine before your household. They're not questioning whether or not you are actually saved or not. They know that you're living a godly life. It's very confusing to spouses that are unsaved and even children to see one parent proclaiming Jesus and yet living a different lifestyle. So then they're left trying to wonder, which one are you? Are you saved or not? But it says here, he says, your genuine faith, for you share the faith that first filled your grandmother Lois, and then he says, your mother Eunice, and he said, and I know that the same faith continues strong in you. Now I want to tell y'all this story as I was studying, and it's actually true that from generation to generation, you can pass down your faith or your belief, or from generation to generation, you can pass down dysfunction and a curse. And it will just keep going down generation after generation until somebody steps up and say, it stops here with me. I'm a child of the Most High King. I'm the head and not the tail. I will not be overcome. I am an overcomer. I'm more than a conqueror through Christ Jesus. Somebody in your family has to stand up. Now, I want to give you this parallel, and it was so interesting. It said, here's a shocking example from history. They said in 1874, a member of the New York State Prison Board noticed that 6 members of the same family was incarcerated at the same time. So it says the board did a research looking back some generations to try to find out who the original couple was who initiated this tragic family legacy. So they traced the family line back to an ancestor born in 1720, a man considered, now listen to this, he was lazy, he was godless, with a reputation around town of being a troublemaker, he was always drunk, he was viewed having low moral character. And he said, to make matters worse, he married a woman that was just like him. And it says they had 6 daughters and 2 sons. But listen, over the lineage from 1720 to 1874, listen to what they produced. 310 of them were homeless. 160 of them were prostitutes. 180 of them suffered from drug and alcohol abuse. 150 of the family members were criminals that spent their life in prison, and 7 of them for murder. And you don't want God to be first in your family? It passed down from generation to generation to generation to generation. But then they decided to do a contrast. And listen to this one. It said there was another family whose heritage was studied, and it involved a couple who lived about the same time. This second family study began with a famous preacher named Jonathan Edwards. It said who was born in 1703. He was a deeply religious man. He lived a life of strong morals and values. He became a minister, and he was dedicated wholeheartedly to his family. He married a woman that was just as deeply religious. Now, I'm not saying religious in that false religious, but they were genuine Christians. Her name was Sarah. And it said they shared the same kind of values. They had 11 children. And eventually, Jonathan Edwards became the president of Princeton University. And the researcher said, let us go back down this lineage and see what this family produced. Can I tell you what they produced? When God says, if you will put me first in your family, that I will cause you to be successful, happy, and blessed, he means exactly what he's saying. And it says that they produced 13 were college presidents, 65 were college professors, 100 of them were attorneys, 32 were judges, 85 wrote books, 66 of them were physicians, 80 of them held political office, 3 were state senators, and 1 became the vice president of the United States. Come on now. Come on now. Ungodly household versus godly household. Look what the Lord can do through your lineage. But it requires us to be faithful to God and His Word. Now, can we go a little bit further? That's good news.